Hi, this is Vincent from Wolfland Productions, and today I'll be going over how to wirelessly sync your Zune, as well as the good things, the bad things, and some just random information that can benefit you in syncing your wireless. Alright, first what you want to do is open up your Zune. Alright, now give it a couple of seconds because I just connected mine in, but it takes a while for it to register. Here's my device. Now I'm going to stop its update for now. Then I'm going to go over to settings. Go over to wireless sync. And I disabled mine, so I'm going to show you how to set it up in real time. Go to setup wireless sync for this network. Next. Click continue. Now it's going to connect to my network, which will take it a few seconds. Alright, now it's done. Now it is wirelessly synced enabled. And now I'll show you that it can sync wirelessly. For one, I will stop the system, disconnect it. Now you see this is back on again. Well, to prove to you that this is syncing wirelessly, I'll go back to my settings and then go over to wireless sync. Now it had the options before, but now it's saying to configure wireless sync, connect with your sync cable. So the bad thing is that sure, you can wirelessly sync, which is a good thing, but it does take up your battery power. The other problem is say, like I said before, if you want to sync it with your computer, but you never did the whole process to set it up. If you lose your cable, then you can't set it up that way anymore. So practically you're screwed until you get another cable. Alright, now I'm just going to switch over to my video camera and I'll show you something else about this. Alright, there's my laptop and I'm going to show you something here. Now it's a little hard to see, but if you can see that right, it only has one light on right now. Of the three lights it has, it only has one on. And I'm just gonna adjust this again, see if I can get a... There we go. Now the thing is that a lot of people say the closer your laptop is, the easier it'll sync with it, or the faster, or it'll have better signal. That is wrong. My wireless network is downstairs across from my house. I'm all the way upstairs across from my house, and it's having one bar. Now my laptop here, this guy right here, has four bars, so that's another thing. This doesn't have as much as a range as a regular laptop would. So it doesn't matter how close they are, if this one has like one bar, this one will have no bars, because my laptop has a better wireless card. Now I'm going to take this downstairs and show you what I mean. Now I was able to get up to my other Samsung TV, and this one will actually show the wireless. So let's go ahead and go to wireless. Oops. And the wireless is on. Make sure it's on. Then sync. And sync to computer. There we go. Now, since I'm downstairs, the lights, as you saw, came back up. And I know they're a little bit difficult to see, but these three lights are now working because the wireless is right next to me. Actually, it's not next to me, it's through that wall, the other room. The router has nothing to do with it, but I still suggest that you have the router on there anyway, because you still want to take other information, like let's say if you want to go to the marketplace. Now this is where your wireless does take place with your modem. Yes, connect now. And now it's going to scan for wireless. And no, for it to go to a marketplace, it can be any network. It does not have to be set up with your laptop. My network just happened to be the closest one that the Zune can see, and the only one with the code I actually have. The other ones are all locked. Alright, now it's connected. And now it's updating content. Now this is really the only time that you're going to need a modem with the wireless in to sync it this way. And after that brief instruction video, in a moment I'll be switching over to the other room and show you the difference between a modem and a wireless router. Alright, now like I was saying before, all what the Zune really does for your wireless is when you have it wirelessly synced, it goes from it sends a signal from your Zune to your wireless and then to your laptop. This is a laptop it's actually working on. Not just the other computer that's connected to it. And what it does from there is that the information that your laptop is sending to your Zune goes from your laptop straight to your wireless and then straight to your Zune. Now the other thing is that here's just a regular modem and here's the wireless itself. Not all wirelesses will have this little antenna or two antennas. Some will only have one and some don't even have any. The way to tell between your wireless and your modem is that it only has one USB Ethernet port. With wirelesses, it has, let's see if I can get this right, four Ethernet ports, actually five, because the fifth one is taking your Ethernet from here and then putting it to here and then all over the house and whatever stuff is connected to it, such as this computer right here. But like I said, all what the wireless is doing when you're syncing it to your computer is it's acting as a bridge. None of the information from your laptop that's transferring over to here to your Zune, none of it is being saved in here. All what this acts is as a bridge. I can't believe how many people have asked me, does it save to here? No, it doesn't. You still need your laptop to be on. I'm not trying to be mean or anything, but I've had a lot of people ask me that, and it's gotten pretty annoying. So like I said, it only acts as a bridge by taking the information from your computer to your Zune. Anyway, this is Vincent from Full Flame Productions, and thank you for watching this video, and I look forward to seeing you all in another one of my videos.